Good morning, students. Today we are going to see the second prose lesson in our English subject, The Night the Ghost Got In, written by James Grover Thurber. James Grover Thurber was born in the year 1894 and died in the year 1961. He was an American cartoonist, author, journalist, playwright. He was best known for his cartoons and short stories. He was one of the most popular humorists of his time. People in the US liked him very much because of his famous cartoons and short stories. Students, before starting the lesson, let me ask you one question. If anyone asks you, have you seen the ghost anywhere at any time, what will be your answer? Your answer will be no. Not only you, nobody has seen the ghost anywhere at any time. But we are very much afraid of ghost, especially during night. We are very much afraid of going out alone, only thinking of ghost. Students, we are very much afraid of ghost. There was an incident in the author's family also because of only thinking of ghost. Yes, the entire family thought that there was a ghost in their family. That happened during one night. So everyone in their house was very much afraid. So let us see why they were afraid and what happened because of their fear. Let us go into the lesson. The ghost that got into our house on the night of November 17, 1915 raised such a hullabaloo of misunderstandings that I am sorry I didn't just let it keep on walking and go to bed. Its event caused my mother to throw a shoe through a window of the house next door, and ended up with my grandfather shooting a patrolman. Students, did you understand what happened in their house? As they thought there was a ghost in their house. The author did not go to bed thinking of the ghost, and his mother threw a shoe through the window of the house next door, and finally the author's grandfather also shot a patrolman. Patrolman, a police officer who walks or drives around an area to make sure that there is no trouble. They are called patrolmen. Okay, the author's grandfather shot one patrolman thinking that he might be a ghost. They began about 1:15 in the morning. The rhythmic, quick, saddened walking around the dining room table. My mother was asleep in one room upstairs. My brother Herman, the name of the author's brother was Herman, he was in another room. Grandfather was in the attic, in the old walnut bed, which, as you will remember, once fell on my father. When I had just stepped out of the bathtub and was busily rubbing myself with a towel when I heard the steps. Okay, this incident happened about 1:15 in the morning on November 17, 1915. In the morning, this incident, early morning, this incident happened. So the author's mother was asleep in one room upstairs, and his brother Herman was in another room, and his grandfather was in the attic, sleeping in the old walnut bed, sleeping on the old walnut bed. The author says, I had just stepped out of my bathtub and was busily rubbing myself with a towel. So the author was, after taking bath, he was rubbing himself with a towel when I heard the steps. So after finishing, after taking bath, he could hear the steps, the sound, steps sound. They were the steps of a man walking rapidly. So when he came out of the bathroom, he could hear the sound. How was the sound? A man was walking, as if a man was walking rapidly. Rapidly means very fast. A man was walking rapidly inside the house. Definitely, that might have created fear in the author's mind, because someone is walking in a, during the night time, in the early morning, inside the house. Definitely, it will create a fear to anyone. The light from the bathroom shone down the back steps, which dropped directly into the dining room. I could see the faint shine of plates on the plate rail. So, the light from the bathroom also, that shone on the plate rail, that that light shone on the plate rail. I could not see the table. Because of that light, I couldn't see the table, the author says. The steps kept going round and round the table. Okay, where you could see the sound, where could the author hear the noise? Round and round the table at regular intervals. A board creaked. A board creaked when I was trod upon. I supposed at first that it was my father or my brother Roy. The author thinks that the walking step may be his father or his brother, who had gone to Indianapolis, but were expected home at any time. So his brother Herman and his father had gone to Indianapolis town. So name of a town, Indianapolis. So the author thinks that they might have come inside the house. So the footsteps may be his father or his brother. The author thinks like that. I suspected next that it was a burglar. Secondly, the author, there is a doubt in his mind. What is that? The steps, the footsteps might be a burglar, a thief. That may be a thief. A thief might have entered the house. The author thinks like that. It did not enter my mind until later that it was a ghost. So, the author did not think that there must be some ghost inside the house for a long time. After the walking had gone on for perhaps 3 minutes, I tiptoed to Herman's room. I hissed in the dark, shocking him. Up, he said in the low, hopeless tone of a despondent beagle. He always half suspected that something would get him in the night. I told him who I was. So, the author now decides to go to his brother's room. So, going to his room, the author wants to wake up his brother. He says that, I told him who I was. There is something downstairs, I said. He got up and followed me to the head of the back staircase. The steps had ceased. Herman looked at me in some alarm. I had only the bath towel around my waist. He wanted to go back to bed. I gripped his arm. So, he wanted me to go, he advised me to go to your room, because he was asleep, and also So he wanted to, he advised the author to go his room. "There is something down there," I said. Instantly, the steps began again, circled the dining room table like a man running, and started up the stairs towards us heavily, two at a time. The light still shone palely down the stairs. We saw nothing coming. So again, the sounds, they could hear the sounds. Marubadi and the sound avangalukku kekudhu. So romba heavy a kekudhu. The light still shone palely down the stairs. We saw nothing coming. Ana edhume varra mari theriyala. We only heard the steps. We could not see anyone, but we could hear the steps. Herman rushed to his room and slammed the door. So he went inside the room and slammed. So he shut the door very fast. I slammed shut the door at the store step and held my knee against his. So I also entered my, so I went in my room. So the author says, I also went in my room.